jab, something that you keep the cover. So if I'm in here like this, it's a low jab or a low corkscrew. Coming in like this, your partner's gonna hold for an uppercut. So the first punch goes in and brings the person's head down, sets it up for the uppercut. Pop, bam. Then you're setting in for the takedown. I'm gonna come in here. My legs have to be ahead of me. If my legs are on one side of the body, my head has to be on the other, and vice versa. I do a double. I can do a pick and lift like this. A lot of different variety. Your key on training that is really pop. Give them some good conditioning for their belly. Pop, bam, in, head up. Do your carry. Do your single leg. Do your pitchfork, which is basically what this is, with good body mechanics. The key on that is, as I'm coming in like this, where my head is, my hips have to be under that. My back has to arch. Like that. Otherwise, you don't get that lift. And you don't have to do the lift. You can do a double leg takedown. So I'm coming in here, smack. I'm going to go just like this, collapse. Just like that. Shoulder in to get that sound. And then you bind the legs. And you can do the bind, immediately go into, you see how I elevate my feet? I elevate them up so that if I scoot down, I put the double knee bar right in play. So pop, underneath like that, double, you're gonna bind the leg. In this case, my head has to really do the work while I pull in here. This is a continual drive, that's why this leg is out here. So the outside arm is going to be pulling, my head is going to be driving, this is going to be driving. So, just like that, I get my feet to the other side of my body. I do not want to get my feet on this side where my head is. If he wraps my head like this, this is a bad position. So I don't want to be here. If he wraps the head, I want to be here. See, this is defensible. This is something I can play with. This is something I can work out of. This isn't going to crunch my neck. Right now I'm giving him a lot of pressure at the shoulder. He's enjoying it. So, but that's where that goes. Right here I'm compressing the heart and making it hard for him to pull in oxygen. Okay, so all of that combined makes this a really good exercise. So everybody's saying, well, how do I get a person down, blah, blah, blah. I can't do that. You're forgetting that I just went here, pop, then a clean uppercut. First one bends him forward, second one works the uppercut, sends him back in, clears the space for me a little bit, so I've got my time. What do I want to do? Do I want to take this leg, that one, maybe both, maybe move around to their back, that sort of thing. Because right now, he should be dealing with a bit of fuzz, if not being knocked out. You got to remember, it's not just the work here with a fully conscious person. I'm taking this up. That good pop to the gut is going to start things off for you.